Wietse de Jager, a prominent figure in the Dutch radio scene, recently faced a surprising turn in his career trajectory. Having secured the coveted morning radio slot at Radio 538, which many considered insider a pinnacle in the radio industry, he unexpectedly found himself grappling with discontent. The coveted morning hours, often seen as the pinnacle of a radio DJ's career, seemed to lose their charm for Wietse. Following in the footsteps of his predecessor Frank Deen, who took over from the legendary Edwin Evers, Wietse embarked on his morning radio journey alongside his colleague Klaas van der Eerde. However, rather than relishing the opportunity, he began expressing his struggle with the demanding schedule. The seemingly light task of connecting songs and engaging listeners for 3 hours turned out to be draining for him. In a puzzling move, Wietse publicly voiced his desire for a 4-day workweek during a live radio broadcast. This unexpected declaration marked a turning point. Not long after, media mogul John de Mol intervened, pulling Wietse out of his morning slot. Apparently, de Mol had little tolerance for a DJ complaining on air. Meanwhile, Tim Klein stepped into the morning slot with the former sidekicks of Edwin Evers, maintaining a lively atmosphere without the overt complaints. As for Wietse, his future in the radio landscape seemed uncertain. Notably, Patrick Kikke, a prominent radio columnist in the Netherlands, shared intriguing insights. At the Lowlands Festival, he overheard Wietse's ex-colleagues Ivo van Breukelen and Barend van Delen discussing a significant move. It appeared that another Radio 538 DJ was considering a switch to the struggling NPO 3 FM station. Although not directly confirmed, all signs pointed to Wietse. Adding an extra layer of complexity, it was revealed that Wietse was the third choice for this transition. Before him, Tim Op het Broek and Giel Beelen were approached for the shift. Ultimately, the torch was passed to Wietse. While this shift might entail a notable reduction in his salary, it seems that this was the path chosen, requiring Wietse to make a significant adjustment. In the dynamic world of radio, such transitions and challenges are not uncommon. It remains to be seen how Wietse's journey will unfold, as he navigates a new chapter in his career, possibly making his mark at 3FM.